This is an animation based on the procedures described in the PCIe hot plug carrier and I/O board servicing chapter of the SPARC M5-32 and SPARC M6-32 servers service manual. If the PCIe card is a disk drive, refer to the service manual for more instructions. Locate the PCIe hot plug carrier where you want to install an I/O card. Use a grounding strap to protect the equipment from ESD damage. Press the attention button on the carrier. The carrier's LEDs will flash for a few seconds until the I/O card in the carrier is disabled. If the carrier is empty, you can skip this step. When the LEDs on the carrier and the card turn off, they are safe to remove. If the LEDs do not turn off, refer to the service manual for instructions. If the carrier contains an I/O card, label and disconnect the I/O cables. Open the extraction lever 90 degrees. The other end of the lever pushes the carrier partway out of the slot. Pull the carrier out and place it on a static safe workspace. This is the rear of the carrier, and we can see the green tab that opens the carrier. Lift the green tab to unlock the carrier, then swing the top open 90 degrees. Pull out the I/O card or the filler panel. Seat the I/O card in the socket in the carrier. The front edge of the card fits onto a guide pin on the carrier. Close the top of the carrier. The green latch will click into place. Use a grounding strap to protect the equipment from ESD damage. Swing the extraction lever out 90 degrees. Press evenly on both sides of the carrier so that it slides straight into the slot. When the extraction lever reaches the edge of the slot, it will start to close. Push the lever into the locked position. The lever will click into place. If the card requires I/O cables, you can connect them to the card now. Press the attention button to enable the I/O card. The carrier's LEDs will flash for a few seconds. The card's LEDs will show activity when the card is enabled. For questions about this procedure, please refer to the SPARC M5-32 and SPARC M6-32 servers service manual. To view the service manual and related documentation, go to oracle.com/m5-32/docs or oracle.com/m6-32/docs.